Copying and pasting inside Premiere Pro can be as simple or as customized a task as you want it to be. For example, right here I have a blue clip labeled example, and I want to copy and paste that. So I'll highlight that, I'll hit Command C on Mac or Control C on Windows, move my playhead to where I want to paste the clip, and one tip here is to use your arrow keys, the up and down, if you want to move the playhead between edit points. So all those cuts in my clips, I'm moving the playhead to there. Let's say I want to paste that clip right here. So on Mac, I would hit Command V. On Windows, that would be Control V, and that's the easiest way to copy and paste. But by default, inside Premiere Pro, it will copy and paste to the same track. So I copied this example clip on V2. That means when I paste that clip, it will paste on V2. To prove how that works, here we have a similar example. Let's say all of this was B-roll, and here is my actual timeline that I want to put my B-roll on top of. So I want to put it on V2. But all of this footage is on V1 and A1. So if I were to highlight this, hit Command C, hit Command V, it pastes right over my A roll, which is not what I want to do. So one tip that you could do here is nudge your clips one track up and one track down. So if I hold Option on Mac or Alt on Windows, highlight my clip and hold Option and the up key, that will nudge that visual up. So the more I hit the up key, it just disappears into the abyss of above V6. If I go back down, there we go. I'm going to hold Option and click this one. And the reason I'm holding Option is because these clips are linked. So if I click this, that means they both are highlighted. If I click this one, it highlights both the video and the audio. If you don't want to do that, that's where you hold Option and click the either audio and or video and go down. Another way to do that is just to turn off link selection. So that's this little icon up here in your timeline. It says link selection, turn that off. Now I don't have to hold any modifiers while I'm selecting the clip. So I want to move this one up. So I'll select it. Then I will hold Option or Alt and do my up key. Let's say I want to take this clip and paste it right up here on V4. So I'll highlight the clip, Option up to V4, hit Command C and Command V, and there we have it. There's a much faster workflow if you're pasting a lot like this, and I'll get to that after I talk about paste inserting. Let's say I wanted to take all of these green clips and just see what it would look like in my story if I flip-flopped this whole section with maybe this red section. We're kind of getting into Christmas colors here. So I'll highlight all of these, and just to demonstrate, instead of copying, I'm going to cut it out. So I'll hit Command X or Control X on Windows to cut it out. I'll move my playhead to the beginning of the red section. Again, a good tip here is to use those arrow keys so I'm at the very butt end or the very beginning of the red section. So I'll hit that up key. I would want it to stop right here, but it's not stopping right here because V2 is selected. That's my track targeting. If I were to turn this off or unhighlight that, now whenever I move my down and up keys, it will just go to each edit point on the timeline. If I were to do V3 right here and then hit the up key, it takes the playhead all the way to the next edit point on V3. I don't want to try and confuse you, even though it's probably confusing you, hopefully not. I'm going to hit the down key till I get to that spot. And to paste insert, you would hit Shift Command V on Mac or Shift Control V on Windows. Now I have inserted that green section. Looks like we got a little bit of blank space right there, which is okay. We'll patch that up. And I will click in here and hit delete to ripple delete that. And paste inserting is a simple way to flip-flop whole sections of your timeline easily without getting your clips all messed up in the hierarchy of where they're at on your sequence. So before I mention, there is an easier way to paste your clips to the track that you want to and not have to worry about hitting Option up or Option down to move them before you paste them to the same track. And that process is called copying and pasting to track target. We've already kind of touched on this before with these right here. These are your track targets. So whatever is highlighted is you're targeting that track. To demonstrate what this looks like, we need to go into our keyboard shortcuts. So I'm gonna hit Option Command K on Mac or Alt Control K on Windows. That brings up our keyboard shortcuts. As you can see, I'm in Adobe Premiere Pro default. Down here, I'm going to type in the word paste, and we're just gonna scroll on down to the timeline panel. And right here, you can see the two options that I've already taught you or demonstrated. Paste insert to same track and paste to same track. Now, in the olden days, which by that I mean like a year ago, The default for this was paste insert to target track and paste to target track. Newer versions, this is default, but I want to show you paste to target track. If you're used to Premiere Pro, you probably already know this. For this demonstration, I'm going to delete the keyboard shortcuts for paste to same track and paste insert to same track, and I'm going to replace those with their target track equivalents. So paste insert to target track, I'll click in this negative space, hit Shift Command V, and paste to target track, I'm going to click in the negative space and hit Command V. Hit OK. And let's say we had these two clips right here that I want to paste above this section. I want to paste the audio and the video along with that. So instead of sitting here and having to option click or unoption click and move the things up, all we have to do is highlight both clips, hit copy. So I'm copying that clip and I can see that there's stuff on A1. I don't want it to paste over A1. So I'm going to highlight A2 and I can see that there's everything between V1 and V3. So I'm going to highlight V4, move my playhead to where I want it to go, hit Command V to paste, and it has pasted to my target tracks, that being A2 and V4. One thing to take into consideration here is it will always paste to the lowest number of your target track. To demonstrate that, let's say I have V5, V6, and V7. Over here, I will have A2 through A4. If I move my playhead over and hit Command V, notice that it did not paste to V7 or V6, A3 or A4. It always pastes to the lowest number in the hierarchy, so V5 and A2. You should also know that the same principles apply here to text-based editing. Here is that same timeline. I have my transcript for the entire sequence already done. If you don't know where your text window is, just go up to Window and hit text, and that will bring up your text window. If you haven't transcribed your sequence yet, there should be some buttons here for you to hit transcribe, and then you'll get a window similar to mine. My transcript's already done. I'm going to highlight this entire section, and that will create an in and out right there. And if I were to right click, and let's say I want to cut it out, so I'm going to extract that. And because my default keyboard shortcuts are still set to paste to target track instead of same track, when I paste this onto the timeline, it should paste to V5 and A3. It should not paste to V1 and A1 and so forth. So I'm gonna hit Command V and look, it pasted to V5 and A3. I'm gonna go back into my keyboard shortcuts right here, go back to paste, and just to prove it to you, let me go to paste, I'll switch this back. Now that we're in default, when I hit paste, it should paste down here instead of up in V5 and A3. So I'm gonna hit Command V, and there we go. It's pasting to the same track versus track targeting. Now there are two more big key factors I need to go over when it comes to copying and pasting. The first one being copying and pasting attributes from one clip to another, or more importantly, one clip to a whole bunch of clips. Let's say right here with my talking head video, for some odd reason, I wanted to have it black and white. So I'm gonna hit Shift-7 on my keyboard to bring up my effects controls, and I'm just gonna look up the stock black and white. Drag that onto my clip, and I'm gonna hit Shift-5 to bring up my effects controls for this clip. And if I scroll on down, you can see that it has the black and white effect. Just to demonstrate, I'm going to hit this opacity. So right here, I've created a square, and let's say it's just over my face like that. And I'm gonna maybe add some rotation and scale. This is a overblown example, but I just wanna demonstrate this. So if I were to go right here and hit Command C, or just to really showcase this, I'm going to right click and hit copy. If I went to this clip right here, right click here and go to paste attributes, that brings up this window. I can now paste specific kind of attributes and effects from that previous clip that I copied in my clipboard to this one. I can do the motion, I can do the opacity, that black and white effect. So instead of bringing in that cropped box, I'm not going to click opacity, but I'm going to rotate it and whatever else I did, I'm gonna keep the black and white, hit okay. Notice that it has not cropped in that little box that I had, but it did rotate it and it made it black and white. Another version of this is with all of these clips, if I highlight them all, let's use some keyboard shortcuts. So I'm gonna hit Option Command V. For those of you on Windows, that's Alt Command V. Brings up your paste attributes window. And instead of doing the motion, I just want them to be black and white. I'll hit OK. And now all of these clips have that black and white effect. On the flip side of this, if I right click all of these and go to remove attributes, in here we could pick and choose which attributes we want to remove. For this one, maybe I just want to get rid of the black and white. So I'm going to unselect motion, opacity, and time remapping. And because this is selected, it should, when I hit OK, remove the black and white from all of those clips. Paste and remove attributes will speed up your workflow immensely. Another big one that I want to bring up is just copying and pasting markers. For this, let's say this yellow section is something that I was working on and I wanted to pass this off to another editor that's kind of building a master timeline where I was just working on this smaller timeline. So let's say I hit M to create a marker, and I'm just gonna make a bunch of different markers right here. And let's say those were notes to the head editor that's working on the master timeline. So if I highlight all of these clips and I hit Command C, I'm going to go up here to markers, copy paste include sequence markers. Now that's not checked off. So when I go over here to this empty space right here, hit Command V, none of the markers paste over. But let's go back up to markers and scroll on down to copy paste include sequence markers, select that. I'm going to re-highlight my yellow section, hit Command C to copy, and go back over here. And when I paste, we have all of those markers with our clips, as well as our little square reference to our copy and paste attributes. So those are some quick tips, tricks, and things that I do when it comes to copying and pasting within Premiere Pro. If this video was helpful, don't forget to hit that thumbs up. My name's Javier Mercedes, and I hope you're out there living a life of abundance. Bye.